NeuroAIDS refers to the effects of HIV on the brain. So HIV, it turns out, can enter the brain. It can cause brain damage, and it can also set up inflammation in the brain. So it's the body itself can damage the brain because it's trying to combat the virus or its products. So as a result, people can have trouble with memory, with concentrating, with planning, decision making. So all of these activities that are so important in everyday life can be affected. In a large study that we've just completed of more than 1,500 people, about 40% had at least a mild cognitive problem seemingly related to HIV. It may be the case that some of our ARVs are not as good at getting into the brain, that is, they don't penetrate into the central nervous system as well. And there's some data now that is being developed that those that penetrate better may be more beneficial to these brain complications that we're seeing. So one of the messages is that not all ART may be equivalent. It may be equally good at managing the body, but not the brain. One of the accomplishments has first of all been to raise awareness that the brain can be affected in HIV disease. This is something that wasn't as well understood before. Second is, as I've pointed out, the use of certain antivirals that get into the brain better may be more beneficial in preventing or reversing these neurological complications. I think the third area we need to look at is how drugs of abuse interact with HIV, sometimes to produce more damage. A good example is methamphetamine, which itself can damage the brain, but in combination with HIV, it can be a bad thing. So we're very much looking at how that works, what are the mechanisms, how can we prevent these kinds of injuries. I think the final point will be that eventually we will have probably neuroprotective drugs. That is, not drugs that actually combat HIV, but combat all of these other effects that HIV produces, such as inflammation. These are things that will maybe prevent HIV from spreading in the first place, and that is my hope, is that HIV never gets to the brain at all because we don't have HIV. But once we get into the central nervous system complications, as I say, what I would really like to see is better agents at preventing these complications, such as very specific anti-inflammatory agents or other agents that can protect the brain. In the 80s, we had maybe 15% of people who had this very severe dementia. Now it's less than 1% in countries and localities where the modern ARV are available. Unfortunately, in many parts of the world, these ARVs still haven't been completely rolled out, and we still have higher rates of these complications.